Good morning students. In previous classes we have been discussed regarding kinematic equations. Now we are going to prove kinematic equations kinematic equations using calculus method What's the difference between calculus method and graphical method? Means in graphical method just we have been assume a graph with the help of velocity time graph and then we have been prove. Now by using calculus method, so kinematic equations which we can be used only for uniform acceleration, whereas these equations which we can be used for non-uniform acceleration also. So same related, but first one have been proved v equals to u plus at, and second one is s is equals to ut plus half at square, and third one is v square minus u square is equals to 2as. So in order to prove this, so from basically what we have been learned with the help of acceleration, so first one, as if I'm going to prove, so we know acceleration a is equals to dv by dt for small interval of time which we can be used. So as if I have been sent over this side, I can get here as dv is equals to a into dt. So these kinematic equations which we are proving, and a is a constant, that's which is nothing but acceleration is a constant. If you are assuming that velocity which has been changed from initial velocity to final velocity of dv, which is equals to integration of time period from t equals to 0 to t, so a into d. So here, so integration of dv which is nothing but v, so but we should not apply the limits. V is equals to, which I can write here as, so V2 and V1, which is equals to A into, A if you have been taken out constant, we are going to get it as here as a T, from 0 to T. So upper limit minus lower limit, which I can get here as V2 minus V1, which is equals to, so A into T. So this V2 minus V1 is nothing but, which I can take here as V2 is equals to V1 plus AT. Sir, I should have to prove only V is equals to U plus AT, means here from initial velocity U to V, which we can take. With the help of this, I can write here as, which is nothing but V is equals to U plus AT. This is the first kinematic equation which we can prove. So, next one which I should have to prove here as s is equals to ut plus half at square. So with the help of this, we know very well v is equals to, so which I can take here as dx by dt, or we can take here as v is equals to ds by dt also we can take. So with the help of this, which I can write here as cross multiplication, I can get here as, so dx is nothing but, which is equals to v into dt. So integrating on both sides, integration of dx is equals to integration of v into dt. But From basics, we know very well that V is equals to U plus ET. Here, which I can take here as V is equals to U plus AT. So, by substituting this and then upper limit and lower limit, which it is moving from x1 to x2, and here time period, which I can take here as from T1 to T2. So, with the help of this, which I can take here as integration of x1 to x2 dx, which is equals to integration of T1 to T2, which I can write here as V value is nothing but U plus AT. U plus AT, so into DT, which I can take. So you have to prove here as a T. So I can take here as initially, which is nothing but, which I can take here as from time period from 0 to T, which I can take. So by taking this integration differentiation, get cancelled, and we can get here as x is equals to upper limit minus lower limit x1 and x2, which is equals to, so integration of 0 to t, we should have to not to confuse this dt which we are giving multiplying, that's we can get here as u into dt plus a into dt. Here a is a constant. So upper limit minus lower limit, which is nothing but x2 minus x1 is equals to u is a constant. Initial velocity will be same. So u into integration of 0 to t into dt plus a is a constant, and then integrating, so a is a constant, so t into dt between the limits 0 to t. Here x2 minus x1, so final velocity minus initial velocity, which is nothing but displacement, that I can write here as s is equals to integration differentiation get cancelled, we can obtain here as u into t plus a into here t, integration of t is nothing but t square by 2, t square by 2, which is nothing but half a t square. Here you should have to remember, so this is the formula, integration of xn into dx is equals to x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1. This is the formula which we are using in case of integration part, that s is equals to ut plus half a t square. Here upper limit minus lower limit, upper limit is t, lower limit is 0, 0 into anything will be 0. So this will be the second equation, s is equals to ut plus half a t square. Third equation is v square minus u square equals to 2as. With the help of this, we know acceleration a is equals to dv by dt. But in order to prove these equations, we should have to do some adjustment, that which I can take here as this one, which we have been multiplied and divided with respect to ds. I have been taken this, which I can get here as a is equals to, I am changing interchange this ds towards this side and dt towards that side, which I can write here as dv by ds into, which is nothing but ds by dt. So what it will represents, ds by dt, this ds by dt is nothing but, so v is equals to ds by dt from the definition of velocity. We can write here as a is equals to dv by ds into v. I have been sent over this side, which I can take here as, so v into dv, which is equals to a into ds. Siva, I am writing directly V into dV, which is equals to A into dS. So integrating on both sides. So integrating on both sides, V into dV is equals to integration of A into dS. So here A is a constant. So A is a constant. And then here we should have to take between the limits. Lower one as a V, upper limit as a U. And then with the help of this displacement, we can take here as initial point is 0, final point is S. With the help of this integration of V into dV. So here we are having formula same. Integration of x into dx is equals to x square by 2. So with the help of this, which I can write here as V square by 2 by applying, so upper limit and lower limit. Sorry. Here I have been written. Initial velocity u, final velocity v. So v and u, which is equals to A is a constant, S, upper limit and lower limit. So by taking half as a common, I can get here as v square between the limits u and v, which is equals to A into S between 0 to S. So upper limit minus lower limit. So as if I have been sent over this side, upper limit is v square, lower limit is u square, which is nothing but 2as. So this is the third equation. So these are the how we can prove the kinematic equations by using calculus method. So then what is the difference between by using graphical method and then by using this calculus method? Means this calculus method, which is valid for non-uniform accelerations also, whereas kinematic equations, we have been said it is under a constant acceleration or uniform acceleration. Okay, this is the question. If a car at rest accelerates uniformly to a speed of 144 kilometers per hour in 20 seconds, it covers a distance of, that distance which we should have to find. So these are the options. So here we should have to find out the distance. Distance is nothing but S. Here they have been given uniform speed, that is along a straight line. So speed and velocity will be the same in terms of magnitude. So we should have to find out distance. So distance we should have to find. What they have been given? If a car at rest, rest means initial velocity is equals to 0. Initial velocity is nothing but u is equals to 0. So speed, uniformly speed, that's final velocity, v is equals to 144 kilometers per hour. So whenever you are doing numericals, we should have to see the units. Here this in terms of seconds and answer in terms of meters. Velocity they have been given in terms of kilometers. So here kilometer per hour, kilometer is nothing but 1000 meters. 1 hour is equals to 3600 seconds. So cancel 5 and 18. Simply you can write here as kilometer per hour, which is nothing but 5 by 18 meter per second. If you have to write meters per second into kilometer per hour, means 18 by 5. So with the help of this, V is equals to 144 into 5 by 18 meter per second. So 18 ones, 18, 8. So V is equals to 40 meter per second. You should have to convert and then only you should have to do. and then they have been given here as time is equals to 20 seconds. So what we should have to find? So we should have to find out the distance. So what we know, formula distance s is equals to ut plus half a t square. Initial velocity is 0, time is 20 seconds. What about a? Acceleration we should have to find. From kinematic equations, first equation, v is equals to u plus a t. With the help of this, v minus u is equals to, I need to find out the a by t. So v value, they have been given it as 40, so which is nothing but meter per second, and t value is 20 seconds, so 2s, which is nothing but a is equals to 2 meter per second square. So u value, you know, 0, time is 20 seconds, a value is 2. So with the help of this, by substituting this, s is equals to 0 into 20 plus half into 2 into t square. T value is 20 seconds. 2 gets cancelled. 0 into anything is 0. S is equals to, which I write here as 20 into 20, which is nothing but 400 meters. So, option C is the right answer. Okay, ma'am. Next question. A car covers first half of the distance between two places at 40 km per hour and other half at 60 km per hour. The average speed of car is. So if you have been seen this application already have been discussed. So which we have been proved. So we can use the directly formula, or we can use in general also. So they have been given two places. So this is the answer. So between two places, first half, which is nothing but s by 2, they have been given it as 40 kilometers per hour, and other half, other s by 2, with 60 kilometers per hour. So this is the point A and this is the point B, which I have been set. So with the help of this average speed, they have been asked. So average speed, so which is equals to total time. Again, say here they have not been given the time period. Total distance is nothing but s by 2 plus s by 2 is s. So with the help of this definition, v is equals to s by t. I should have to find out the value of t. With the help of this, t is equals to, I can write here as s by v. With the help of this, so t1 is equals to s by 2 into v. V value is 40 kilometers per hour, that is in terms of hours. And t2, which I can get here as s by 2 into, which is nothing but 60, which I can take. So now v average is equals to total distance is nothing but s by s by 2. I have been taken as a common. S by 2 is equals to 1 by 40 plus 1 by 60, which we can do. So with the help of this, v average is equals to ss will get cancelled, so which is nothing but, so 2 by 1 by 40 plus 1 by 60. So which you can do the cross multiplication, so which you can get here as v average is equals to 2 by 60 plus 40, which is nothing but 100 by 40 into 60. So 2400, which I can get here as V average is equals to, if it moves in upwards in direction, 2400 into 2 by 100. So I can get cancel, which is nothing but V average is equals to 48 kilometer per hour. This much of length process we should have to do, no need. So if you have been understood the application, which you can write here as that average speed, V average is nothing but, which we have been proved here as 2V1 V2 by V1 plus V2. So this is a shortcut method which we can use. So with the help of this, V average is equals to, so 2 into V1 value, which is nothing but 40 into 60 by V1 plus V2, 40 plus 60, which is nothing but, which I can write here as same, so 4800 by 100. So V average is equals to 48 kilometer per hour. So you can ask me one more question. Sir, in previous case, kilometers per hour you have been converted into meter per second. Why? There answer they have been given in terms of meters. But here, directly answer they have been given. So you should not have to use 40 plus 60 by 2. We'll get the answer 50, which is wrong. That is applicable for first half of the time and next half of the time. So for that we can use that formula. Next question. Given V is equals to root 4 plus 4 into S meter per second, find displacement of a particle at a time t equals to 2 seconds. Here they have been given velocity V is equals to root of 4 plus 4 S, and then they are asking to find the displacement. So given equation is nothing but V is equals to root 4 plus 4 S. That for velocity unit is meter per second. So we know V square minus U square is equals to 2AS. So the above equation, which I can get here as squaring on both sides, which we can get here as V square is equals to 4 plus 4S, where S is a displacement. But in order to change this, we can move toward this side. V square minus 4 I can write here as 2 square, that's equals to 4S. So comparing this equation with the help of this, which I can get here as U is equals to 2 meter per second. And here 2AS, yes, 2A equals to 4. So 2A is equals to 4. Or if you want me, just here you can write down by comparing. So with the help of this, A value is nothing but 2 meter per second square, because A is a acceleration. Sir, why you have been find out U and A? Because here they asked to find the displacement. So what's the formula for displacement? Displacement formula is nothing but S is equals to UT plus half AT square. Now we know the U value, we know the A value, and then time period is 2 seconds. So S is equals to, U value is 2 into time period is 2 plus half into A value is 2 into T square, that is 2 square, which I can get here as 2 gets cancelled. So S is equals to 4 plus 4. So S is equals to 8 meters. or instead of finding displacement, they may ask to find the initial velocity and acceleration also. The same question, instead of this, find displacement, find initial velocity and acceleration. So u value is 2 meter per second and a value is 2 meter per second square. But in question they have been asked the displacement, s is equal to ut plus half at square, we can get the answer. So next question is, if Sn is equal to 2 plus 0.4 into n, find initial velocity and acceleration. So these are the options which they have been given. U is equal to 1.1, a is equal to 0.5, u is equal to 2.2, a is equal to 0.2, u is equal to 2.2, a is equal to 0.4, u is equal to 1.1, a is equal to 0.2. By seeing this equation, which we can find here as, this is in the form of equation Sn is equal to u plus a into n minus half. This is the equation. But the given equation is Sn is equal to 2 plus 0.4 into n. We cannot compare directly. For this, what we can do means we can add and subtract. So 0.4 by 2 minus 0.4 by 2. So which will be get cancelled, and then we can get the same equation. So Sn is equals to now 2, I'm taking toward this side, plus 0.4 by 2 plus 0.4 into n minus 0.4 by 2. What we can observe, 0.4 is a common. So 2, 0.2, 2 plus 0.2. So Sn is nothing but, so 2.2 plus 0.4 into n minus half. Now you can compare this equation. U value is 2.2, a value is 0.4. So initial velocity u is equals to 2.2 meter per second and acceleration a is equals to 0.4 meter per second square. So option C is the right answer. Okay students, next question. The two ends of a triangle moving with a uniform acceleration passes a certain point with the velocities u and v. Find the velocity with which the midpoint of the train passes the same point. Then four options they have been given. So you can make it pass and then you can try it. So here, solution. You have been taken two ends of a train. So the two ends which I can take here as like this. Its train is moving with a uniform acceleration and passes a certain point with the velocities u and v. So let it be initial velocity and this is a final velocity v. So find the velocity with which at midpoint. So this total distance is s. I can take this as s by 2. I can take this as s by 2. So find the velocity with which the midpoint of the train passes the same point. So this velocity I can take here as a v1. So with the help of this s by 2, and then they have been given uniform acceleration. So in uniform acceleration, which we can use a formula as v square minus u square is equals to 2as. So initial velocity, final velocity, v square, that is v1 square minus u square equals to 2as. That displacement will be the same, which is nothing but s by 2 I can take. In the same way, next, from here to here, now this is the initial velocity, this is a final velocity. So v square, so v square minus v1 square is equals to 2a into s by 2. Half of the distance, LHS are equal, we can equate the RHS. So these RHS are equal, we can equate the LHS. So with the help of this, which I can write here as, so assume that equation 1, equation 2, from 1 and 2, we can write here as v1 square minus u square is equals to, which is nothing but v square minus v1 square. So if I have been moved toward this side, which I can get here as 2v1 square is equals to, which is nothing but u square plus v square. I need to find out the value of v. So for that, which I can write here as v1 square is equals to u square plus v square by 2. I need to find out the value of midpoint. V is equals to root of u square plus v square by 2. Here question is very simple, but understanding is very, very important. C is the answer. A rifle bullet loses 1/20th of its initial velocity in passing through a plank. What will be the least number of such planks required to just stop the bullet? Here one plank I am taking, so which is having some thickness x. So in order to pass this, here initial velocity is v, and then its velocity will be lost by 1/20th. In its original velocity, 1/20th it will be losses, that is v minus v/20, that's which is nothing but 19v/20, which I am going to get. This is for one plank. For n number of planks, I can take here as like this, it will be having n number of planks having same thickness. Just to understand you only, I am taking like this. So how many number of planks means you don't know. Each plank thickness is x. So here initial velocity is v and final velocity will be equals to 0. With the help of this equation, v square minus u square. So final velocity. Final velocity is 19/20 v whole square minus initial velocity is v, which is equals to 2as. S is nothing but x. For a such number of planks, because the final velocity must be 0. Final velocity must be 0. For that, final velocity is 0 and initial velocity is v. V square is equals to 2a into nx. Because here we don't know how many number of planks. The planks only we should have to find here. So with the help of this, n is equals to, I can write here as minus v square by 2ax. Here 2ax value is a, we can substitute that. So n is equals to, so minus v square, that is minus v square will be like this, 2ax. 2ax equals to 19/20 into v whole square minus v square. So in order to remove this minus, just we can make, so n is equals to v square by v square minus 19/20 whole square into v square. V square we can take out as a common. So n is equals to, it will be gets cancelled, 1/1 minus 19/20 whole square. So n is equals to 1/1 minus 19 whole square into 19. 9 is 81, 9 1 is 9 plus 171 into 19. 1, 7 plus 9, which is nothing but 16, 360, 1. So 361 by 20 into 20 is nothing but 400. So n is equals to 1 by 400 minus 361 by 40, which is nothing but 400 we can get. If you have been calculated this, we can get here as 400 by 361, 39. So 400 by 39 by 40 approximately will get 10. That's n value is nothing but we can get here as 10.3. We cannot take 0.3, no, because here number of planks. So in order to come to rest, we need number of planks is nothing but 11. So 11 is the right answer. Okay students, this is regarding some numericals based on the previous concept. Please subscribe my channel and share to your friends. If you have any doubts, just you can comment me. Thank you, students.